That woman is sleeping with her husband, her husband's father, and his father's brother.
Wow. Is that the father?
No, that's the husband. That's the father.
Oh, dear. He looks very tired.
You'd think she'd wash her hair. I mean, you know you're going on telly, so you'd wash your hair, wouldn't you?
Well, she's been quite busy. Maybe she didn't have time.
Inka gives herself an hour's preparation time before she leaves the house. You could take a leaf out of her book, James. Did you tell your husband things were boring when you had
affairs? You all right?
Yeah, I miss her. The cleanliness, the order, the microbiotic food regime.
You'd never have guessed.
Could you go around and see her for me?
Oh, no, I don't want to get involved.
You are involved. You're the reason why I'm here.
No, Jason, you're the reason why you're lying on the sofa like a giant sausage roll.
Girls, get a wiggle on. Brownie camp. Coming.
Billy, sup on my raw veg, will you?
Sorry?
My gazpacho. Oh, have a taste.
Usually get Poppy's sophisticated palate onto it, but she's away at brownie camp, so.
I'll do my best.
It's a cold tomato-based soup originating from the southern regions of Andalusia.
You know, I'm just not a soupy kind of guy. You know, anything liquidy as a main meal just kind of creeps my taste buds out. But I'm sure Gemma will love it.
Well, I haven't settled on a final menu yet, so.
Oh, Try one of these.
A little piece of heaven in a ramekin.
You want me to take a souffle on the bus?
Oh, yes. Ah. And text me your thoughts, eh? LOL, smiley face.
Right, baggy crispies and a little tart.
You should do salads, you know. I have an irritable bowel.
Oh. Well, I'll make sure I tell my boss. Not about your bowel thing, about the salad thing. I bet you don't have an irritable bowel.
No. Can I have a cheese and pickle baguette, chicken pine nut wrap and some crisps?
Light style. Certainly no bowel issues there.
No. My bowels are fine, thanks.
There's a little something extra in the cheese and pickle baguette.
You are very lucky I was able to fit you in. People highly demand me.
Oh, thanks, Inka. Yes, I'm going to dinner at Tom's tonight.
Tom is a snatch.
Catch.
Go behind screen and slipping off clothes. There are paper pens in there for your safety.
Thanks. So how are you, Inka?
Did Jason send you?
No, I didn't tell him I was coming.
He misses you.
My heart is stone, Yama.
Please, onto the couch. You want to wax while you're here?
No, thanks.
Probably a mistake.
Oh, well, it's just friends having dinner. No funny business.
You're burying your head in a suit.
Maybe. What about you? Aren't you burying your head in a... Ow!
Tension balls.
Oh, Inka, the thing is, you and Jason are just so totally made for each other.
I think so too. He was the deep fried fish to my organic parsnip chips.
High cholesterol salt to my filtered balsamic vinegar. Basically, Yama, he was the pink to my pong.
But now I have thrust forward with my life.
Ooh, I have done. Husbandhunter.co.uk.
Inka, he has broken a hoop of trust.
Oh, Inka!
What?
Yeah. Ooh, you're hurting me.
Sorry, I forget you're frail. Turn. You see this?
No.
This is a white platinum engagement ring that I'm imagining Jason gave me. It is having a prong set with a round, brilliant diamond solitaire embraced by a sparkling micropavate halo setting. Give him the ring back.
Oh, I'm not sure I know how to give back a...
It is fine. I have a date tonight at the bar with businessman Terry Tompkinson, 44, from Northwood Hills.
Oh, no, Inka, don't. Come round to mine and see Jason.
Jason who? Lie.
but he loves me. He's just a poor boy from a poor family.
I'm not listening to that. Oh, now.
Go, little Willa. No, we will not let you go.
I went to the Inca today, and she gave me back her imaginary engagement ring. It's over. She's even going on a date tonight.
She moves fast.
Jason thinks she's going to take him back.
Yeah, well, he would. You've got to tell him.
I know. I need moral support.
I've got plans.
Alfie.
Fine.
Come
on. Let me go. Beelzebub has a devil put aside.
Jason, now, there's no easy way to say this, so I'm just going to blurt it out. I went to see Inca today, and she said to give you this back. I'm sorry.
What's she giving back?
It's the imaginary engagement ring you never bought her.
She's being dramatic. She'll have me back.
Jason, she's moving on. She's going on a date tonight.
She's doing what?
She's going on a date.
With who?
Businessman Terry someone. It's not the point.
Well, I'm going down there.
No.
No, I'm going to give that bloke a jolly good shoeing.
Shoeing?
She's a fragile, rare butterfly. She needs protecting, otherwise she'll just end up on some rich geezer's wall with a pin stuck through her torso. I've never loved anyone the way I love her. Never. I'm going down there.
No, Jason, no! You're only going to make things worse. There's no way she'll take you back if you go down there all guns blazing. Is there, Alfie?
What? Oh, no.
Say something.
Yes.
What?
Well, yeah, okay, Mum's right. You'll end up looking more of a plank than you're doing that little slanket thingy.
Thanks for those pearls of wisdom.
Welcome.
Supposing this geezer's a murderer!
No, I'm sure Inca can take care of herself. But what I do propose is that, that Alfie go down to the bar to keep an eye on her.
What? No, I can't do that. I've got a booty text. Cheese and Pickle Girl got the number I hid in her baguette.
This is a family emergency, Alfie.
So get Billy to do it. He's working at the bar tonight.
Oh, I don't know.
Well, I would feel better if I knew someone was watching over her. No, forget it. I'm going there myself.
No, Jason. Stay here. I'll sort Billy out. I mean, I'll sort it out with Billy.
I'm going to be all alone. The girls are out. You're going out. You're going out. Inca's even going out.
Oh, good. You're here. Look, sorry, but I haven't got time for the whole flirty thing you do.
Flirty thing?
Yes, you say stuff to me and I get all hot and flustered and then I'm not sure if it's attraction or the menopause. Anyway, I haven't got time for that. I need to get to the point.
Well, you're doing well so far.
Oh, thank you.
So, you wanted us to get down to business?
Oh, yes. No, it's not about us. Look, I need you to do a little bit of spying. Well, not spying exactly, more keeping an eye on.
So you want to hire me as a detective?
Well, not hire you so much, more ask you to as a favour.
Ah, free detective work. You know, I don't normally keep an eye on people for nothing. Is it Alfie? Is he wearing women's clothes again?
What? No, it's Inca. She's coming down here to meet businessman Terry, someone, for a date. Does Alfie wear women's clothes?
Oh, no.
Listen, I've had to practically sedate Jason with bacon sandwiches to stop him from coming down here and making a scene.
Well, maybe he should do. Show Inca how he feels. Stop pretending that there isn't anything.
Is this about us again?
Definitely not. This is spy business. Would you stop bringing it around to us all the time? Ow! Is that how you treat all your employees?
No, just stop it. This is serious. Jason comes down here and starts getting all macho. It's going to make things a lot worse than they are already.
Okay, understood. So you'd like me to keep an eye on Inca and report back to you?
Yes.
Do we have code names?
I'm serious. You text me and let me know what's going on.
Should I intercept if our client is in danger?
Well, yes, obviously.
You want me to put my life on the line for you, then?
Now, you... stop it. I'm going. You...
I would.
Yeah,
so would I.
All right.
I'm just waiting for someone.
Yeah, me. You put your number in my baguette, so here I am.
No, I put my number in Cheese and Pickle Girl's baguette.
No, she was the chicken and pie nut. I'm the cheese and pickles.
Oh. Well, this is awkward.
Only if you're not gay.
Not gay.
So, yes. It's a bit awkward.
For you are mine. At last.
Oh. Sorry I'm late.
Well, it's 22 minutes. Nothing's ruined. Lovely to see you. Come on in.
Oh, great. Tom. The thing is,
Jason!
Yes, that's the thing. Jason.
Just parking. Right, Tom.
Jason's had a bit of bad news. Inca's on a date.
And I want to go down there and batter the man, but Gemma won't let me!
Sorry, Tom, I just couldn't leave him on his own. It's all been a bit last minute.
I have plenty for three. You're doing the grown-up thing, Jason.
No, I can't do it. I'm not grown up. I'm going down.
No,
there.
Jason, be sensible. Now, Billy's there, and he's going to be keeping an eye on things.
Oh, well, that's all right, then. It's much better this way, Jason. Yeah, I made a terrible fool of myself when Selena moved in with Imran. I exploded at the Asda meat counter, hurling a salami at him. Wait it out, and go and speak to her tomorrow, calmly and with dignity.
I'm so sorry about all of this.
You've all got baggage, Jim.
Yeah, well, I brought mine with me. Literally.
Can I take your coat, Gemma? Yeah. And, Jason, your, blankety thing.
Billy, a couple of pints for me and my date, cheese and pickle.
Don't ask.
Did Mum ask you to spy on Inca?
Yeah, she wants me to make notes and update her.
Hurry, James Bond.
Quiz machine?
Sure. Why not?
You know, Casanova was a spy for the Venetian Inquisitors of State in between his womanizing.
Yeah, I expect I'd be like him if I was a spy. Ah, I see you more as Mata Hari. Really? I bet he was cool.
Yeah, she was.
Good luck.
Cheers.
Get your own baguette, Dave.
Now this is a beauty birch wine.
Wine from a tree?
Yep. You penetrate the bark, let the sap drip into the bottle, and then you begin the winemaking process.
Damn it, I like it. So you're a bit of a Bear Grylls, then?
Does he make wine?
No, he eats flies and stuff.
Okay, what's the shortest verse in the Bible?
Jesus wept.
All right, I'm only asking.
No, that's the answer. The shortest verse is Jesus wept.
Oh.
Right, in money slang, how much is a Pavarotti worth?
I see, 30.
What? No, hang on.
Inca, you look lovely.
I know. It was hard for me to be doing this dress-up now that I am alone.
I'd be happy to help you with your zip.
There is no zip. Like sausage skin, I did lots of writhing and wriggling on the bed.
I love this bar. What can I get you?
Scotch in the rocks.
Allow me.
Are you my blind date?
No. But I could be.
I'm thinking not. Not exfoliating facially.
There you go.
Yeah, steady with the wine, Jason.
I'm enjoying myself. Lighten up.
So, starters of fresh sardines. Naples style. Drizzled with a garlic and white wine vinaigrette. And the homemade bread on the table is made by Poppy's own fair hand.
This kid makes bread. Our kids make bread. Oh, no, mate, no. Gemma doesn't eat anything with eyes, do you, love?
It's fine. It's fine, I do now.
Really? What, dead googly eyes staring at you?
Stop it, Jason.
Sorry, Gemma, didn't think to ask.
That's lovely, mate.
Well, shall I take the head off?
No, it's fine, I can do it.
Selena, Poppy and I went on a cooking course in Naples on our last holiday together. It was wonderful.
My last holiday with Inca was 5 days on a barge in the Norfolk Broads. Inca turned some heads. She was like a Scandinavian ice queen gliding that barge down those canals. She never let me drive.
The barge she sat in like a burnished throne burned on the water. Shakespeare.
I have to go to her.
No, Jason, you can't. Billy texted, she's not even there yet.
How about I pop open some parsnip champagne? Wonderful beast, the organic parsnip. Champagne yeast, juice of two oranges. Oh, no, quite a potent combination.
That was lovely, Tom. Thank you. Pull up.
They pack a nutritional punch.
That's someone I'd like to punch.
You let them go, and if they come back to you, then it was meant to be.
Your wife never came back from Imran.
Oh, Jason, don't be rude. Then maybe we should go.
No, don't be silly. Jason's right. She didn't. It wasn't meant to be. Let's get the next course ready. Fresh pasta. Please help yourselves to the olives, would you?
What?
Behave.
I am.
So, nervous about your date?
Not so much. I have had many dates. Always ask me on a second date and always I'm saying no.
Ah, but you went on a second date with Jason.
Yes, that's because on the first date he was forgetting his purse, so I paid. So we had to have second dates so he could be reimbursing me back.
I see.
We are Europeans, you and I. Foreigners getting mixed up with the English with their tiny, scared hearts. It is pain-making.
Yeah, but real love is worth the pain, isn't it? I mean, having your heart ripped out is part of knowing you're alive.
But you can't live without your heart, Irish.
Yeah, but you can't live if you keep it to yourself either.
I am wanting to show my love, to yodel it from the mountains. But men in this country, they just cannot do this. Where is Jason now that I am to see another man? I can tell you, eating pig at Yemma's. No, thank you. I'm sorry to disappoint you. I'm sure you have thought all your Easters have come at once upon seeing me, but I have just realized, businessman Terry Tompkinson, age 44 from Northwood Hills, that I'm very much in love with Jason.
Then Jason is an incredibly lucky man.
Yes, he is. You're most astute.
Here's my card. If you ever change your mind.
No, thank you.
So what was wrong with him?
Yes, I know. He had great hairs and fashions. But he just wasn't being Jason.
I think you should take her home.
Oh, sure. Yeah, of course. Of course. But before we go, does anyone know the name of Sherlock Holmes' housekeeper?
Mrs. Hudson.
Be Mrs. Hudson!
Right here!
Yes! Yes!
Tom, that is amazing.
Thank you, Jason.
If I was a woman, I'd marry you. Wouldn't you, James? Jem, you seen this?
Yes, wonderful.
Oh, you got it all going, Tom, haven't you? Huh? Nice house, nice car, you can cook. You're okay looking.
Thanks.
I used to think you were a bit of a nut.
Text.
Is it Billy? What does he say? Has Inka gone on the date?
He says that Inka is at the bar and she seems sad.
She's missing me.
And that the guy arrived. Oh, and he was very good looking.
No, I'm going down there.
No, wait, wait. He says Inka turned him away.
Oh, she still loves me.
Well, maybe he had bad breath.
What else does he say?
Billy says, I want to...
He wants to what? Gemma?
Yes.
Are you all right, Gemma?
Yes, I'm just a bit hot.
Well, you know, there is a gentle afterkick of fresh chilli from linguine. It can take you by surprise.
It certainly can. May I use your bathroom?
Of course, upstairs. First door on the left.
Right! Let's get drunk! What's next on the homemade wine front? Roast potato. Hell is for the way you
had me. Oh, it's for the
Thank you for giving me the rights home.
You're welcome. You know he's all right, really.
Who?
Jason.
He's liar and painmaker with the eyes of the beaver.
Agreed. But he, you know, when he split up with Mum, he didn't have to help out with me, and he did.
Go on.
He always showed up for school stuff, and, well, you know, even though he's a clown and a muppet, he's kind of all right. But if you tell him I said that, I will deny it.
Okay. I'll keep it under my socks.
He loves you, you know?
I know. But I'm not so sure it's enough.
Hang on. Your phone number is in all these baguettes.
You must call her. Reveal your heart.
Think?
Tell her how you feel, man.
Oh, always make a hash of that sort of stuff.
Inca stabbed me with a nail file the last time I tried to be romantic.
Viking women are an enigma. Indeed. But I can help you. I trust you, Tom.
Straight to voicemail.
Leave a message. Tell her that, like her motherland, her beauty is vast and majestic.
Inca, just like your mother, you are vast and big.
Where is the spring and the summer? Where did it go? I just don't know. But still, my love for you will live forever.
Hasta mañana, till we meet again. Don't know when.
I shouldn't even be looking at you, Billy's toothbrush. I should be looking at you, Tom's. All strong and stylish and professional, with three speeds. What do you have?
I'm not sure this is a good idea.
You are primed. You know what to say.
Yo, Selena. Yeah, shut it, sweet cheeks, if you know what's good for you. One thing, your bum does look big, bit big, in jeans. Not so much the black ones, but... Yeah, so anyway, get over yourself.
I'm gonna be in so much trouble.
You still love her, don't you?
I need to stop meeting in bathrooms.
Which would mean meeting in places where other people would see us?
Yes.
Which would mean telling people?
Oh.
Yodeling it from the mountains?
Well, maybe we could just squeak it first.
I can't keep doing this without telling Alfie. You know, it's just not fair.
Gemma! Open the door.
Oh, no. Wait, not now, Jason!
Yes, now. It's urgent.
There's no
one. I'm coming in.
Oh, that's just... Oh, Jason.
It's the bird's wine. Oh, my tummy.
No, I think it's the sardine to peek.
Oh!
Gemma, I think you should go. I don't want you to see us like this.
No! Make us stay. I need a wet compress.
No!
I just want to get a flannel.
No, I'll get it. I like to nurse people. It's what makes me feel whole.
I think you should leave Jason here.
I'm not so sure I should.
It is my fault. I undercooked the sardines. We'll get through this together.
I guess you're right. Okay. Oh, and thank you for a lovely night.
Yeah, work. Work.
Oh, my God. The splits.
Oh, okay, I'll give you some bruises. I'll put some towels on Poppy's back for you. Wait. Come on.
Oh, dear.
Inca, just like your mother, you are vast and big. Where is the spring and the summer? Where did it go? I just don't know. But still, my love for you will live forever.
Till we meet again. Don't know where, don't know where.
I'm in love with Billy. Don't judge me.
I won't.
You're not Fran. Where's Fran?
Gemma, what are you doing here? Are you okay?
She's in love with Billy.
Oh, but hang on. Billy?
Yeah.
Not Tom?
No.
But Billy, he is so...
She doesn't want you to judge.
Well, then she shouldn't tell me. That's what friends do, judge.
Right, well, I'll leave you two to it. Well, not it. Well... Well, probably it.
No, come in. Billy.
Judging.
Not judging, just saying.
Sounded a bit judging.
So what does Gemma really think of the men in her life and how will she decide between them? Read her thoughts at the TV blog website. There's more comedy now on BBC Two. Sue Perkins and Ross Noble in Jeopardy with QI.